Hello everybody, welcome to Pinnacle Online Coaching Classes. In this video lecture, we are going to do Parajumbles Part 18. Part 18 of Parajumbles to be done now. Pinnacle has made a complete series on Parajumbles of 20 video lectures and this is Part 18. This is a very important topic for SSC CGL Tier 2 exam. In fact, it is there in even other exams, but for SSC CGL Tier 2 exam, this topic will have 20 questions in Tier 2. Extremely important, and if you score well in this topic, definitely it's going to make a huge difference to your overall score. This is part 18. And in part 18, we are going to practice some Parajumbles because I have already covered all the rules, all the tricks with you. This video lecture, it's a part of our JobAssure Part 2 program. JobAssure Part 2 program, it's a scientifically designed day-wise systematic program planned after a lot of research for students who wish to score well in their Tier 2. I wish you all the very best, and now let's begin Part 18. First one, many parents set up rules and other boundaries in which their teens must follow. Even though most parents mean well and some rules are necessary, it's easy to overwhelm teens with regulations. These rules are usually placed over their teens to control, protect and teach their teen. First of all, teens are not going to follow all of the rules. Secondly, there are some things that certain teens will not do with or without a specific rule on that subject. For example, there are many teens that would never use drugs, but by placing a rule on this, the teen might not feel trustworthy and might be more likely to take drugs. Now, this is my Parajumble, and now let us look at the keywords. First one here we have even though, then we have these rules, this first, second, for example, many of these are there. Now, let us try to put it in order. Now here, if you see, many parents set up rules and other boundaries in which their teens must follow. These rules, which rules are we referring to? We are referring to the rules set up by parents. These rules are usually placed over their teens to control, protect and teach their teen. Probably Q is going to be my first one. Here we have, for example, there are many teens that would never use drugs, but by placing a rule on this, the teen might. Now here an example has been given. In the sixth sentence, an example has been given. This is going to be preceded by, there are some things that certain teens will not do with or without a specific rule on that subject. So S is going to be my last one. Q as the first one, S as the last one is in option B. Now let us try to do this. Then in between we have first. We have first and we have even though. So obviously R is definitely going to be before S. R is definitely going to be before S. So R is before S here also because R has first and S has secondly. Let me try to fit in B. Many parents set up rules and other boundaries in which their teens must follow. These rules are usually placed over their teens to control, protect and teach their teen. Then P, even though most parents mean well and some rules are necessary, it's easy to overwhelm teens with regulations. First of all, teens are not going to follow all of the rules. And then secondly, there are some things that certain teens will not do with or without a specific rule on that subject. For example, there are certain teens that would never use drugs, but by placing a rule on this, a teen might not feel trustworthy and might be more likely to take drugs. So my answer is going to be B. B will be the right answer. Next one. To me, pursuing a career in business is a very important for my future welfare. Through him, I have discovered my own interest in the business field. My father is a businessman in Taiwan and I have had numerous opportunities to watch him work. At the same time, my father has made me believe that it is possible to be an honest businessman in Asia. I find the way business operates in the East to be very exciting. Honesty goes a long way to build clients and win their faith. Very simple Parajumble. Now let us see the keywords. Here we have through him. Now we need to question, what does this him refer to? At the same time, this is another important one. Now here we are talking about the East. East here meaning in a way kind of referring to Asia, because here he has mentioned that his father is a businessman in Taiwan. So now here also we have mentioned Asia. Here also we have mentioned the eastern part of Asia. R and S. Probably they both will go together. They both will go together, R and S. And which one will we find first? We will first fit in S and then we will fit in R. S and then R. Now, what is him referring to here? Him is referring to his father. His father is being referred to here. So the noun pronoun formula, first Q will be there and then P is going to be there. First Q and then P. So where is Q? Q is here followed by P. Let me fit it in now. To me, pursuing a career in business is very important for my future welfare. My father is a businessman in Taiwan and I have had numerous opportunities to watch him work. Through him, I have discovered my own interest in the business field. I find the way business operates in the East to be very exciting. At the same time, my father has made me believe that it is possible to be an honest businessman in Asia. Honesty goes a long way to build clients and win their faith. See, very simple. R is definitely going to be the last one. Why? So, because the same thought process of honesty is continued in line 6. So, obviously, C is my right answer. C is the right answer. Next one to be done. Europeans are not used to the serpentine queues we encounter in the Indian subcontinent. We line up even for our filthy public toilets and to pay the electricity bills. We wait eternally at railway crossings, ration shops and bank counters. Particularly so in Europe, where it is claimed that God is dead and religion defunct. Hence, the fact that millions and mostly the youth made it to the funeral of Pope John Paul II, braving long journeys and queuing up for hours on end is truly remarkable. That the European youth was willing to go through these hardships to pay tribute to a spiritual head was unthinkable. This is my Parajumbles, and now let me try to look for the keywords here. Now here it says particularly so in Europe. This so is a keyword. Hence the fact, this hence is an important keyword, was willing to go through these hardships. Which hardships are we referring to? That is a keyword here. Now let us take a look. Let us take a look in here. If you see the last one, it says that the European youth was willing to go through these hardships to pay tribute to a spiritual head was unthinkable. It was unthinkable. Prior to this, we will have particularly so in Europe, where it is claimed that God is dead and religion defunct. Probably this could be the last one. Now here, if you see, S and R are in a way linked. They are in a way linked. Hence the fact that millions and mostly the youth made to the funeral of Pope John Paul II, braving long journeys and queuing for hours on end is truly remarkable. S is going to be followed by R. Now see, here we are talking about generally the fact that mostly youth made it to the funeral of Pope John Paul II, braving long journeys and queuing for long hours is truly remarkable. Particularly so in Europe, we are moving from general to specific. Okay, we are moving from general to specific, particularly so in Europe, especially in Europe where they queued up in long lines. This is remarkable because over there, most of the people are atheist and they claim God to be dead. So S is going to be followed by R towards the end. And we have S followed by R towards the end here and here. Now we need to find out whether Q is going to be followed by R or Q is going to be followed by P. Oh, S towards the end is only in option D and not in option B. S followed by R. That is what we need. It is an option D. S followed by R. Now let me try to fit up. Europeans are not used to the serpentine queues we encounter in the Indian subcontinent. We wait internally at railway crossing, ration shops and bank counters. We line up even so. See, this even is a hint. So P is going to be the second one and Q is going to be the first one. So Q, P, S, R, this is my answer. My answer is D. D is the right answer. Next one. The introduction of television. The introduction of television to America forever affected the society and still affects the society at present time. When children watch TV programs, they copy the actions and morals of those programs. Between the age of 1 and 5, one easy access to entertainment is television. On that day in the evening, my nephew had built a tower by Lego. We are all familiar with the WC Towers tragedy. He took a toy plane and tried to hit that toy tower, showing me that it will fall as he had watched news on TV. Now here, on that day, which day are we referring to? Which day are we referring to? We need to find out. Now, we all are familiar with the W.C. Tower's tragedy. He took a toy plane and tried to hit that toy tower. Which toy tower are we talking about? Which toy tower are we talking about? We need to know that. Now, in all of these, R is the last one. So, R is going to be the last one. On that day in the evening, my nephew had built a tower by Lego. And it is this tower which is being referred to in line 6. So, R is my last one. Now, here. When children watch TV programs, they copy the actions and morals of those programs. Between the age of 1 and 5, one easy access to entertainment is television. We all are familiar with the W.C. Tower's tragedy. Now, in R and 6, the W.C. Tower's tragedy has been mentioned about. So, R is going to be immediately preceded by which line? R is going to be immediately preceded by S, because here also we are mentioning about the W.C. Tower's. S is going to be here. And S and R as the last one are in option A and in option B. So first one is going to be which one? First one is going to be this one. Between the age of 1 and 5, one easy access to entertainment is television. This is general. And then specific, when children watch TV programs, they copy the actions and morals of those programs. So answer is going to be QPSR, and QPSR is in option A. My answer is option A, correct one. Next one is going to be, the word victory generally reminds us of wars and conquerors like Alexander and Napoleon. Thousands of people are killed and hundreds of towns and cities are destroyed. But the victory associated with a war comes after so much of destruction. In this category, we may include the achievements of scientists and scholars, statements and social reformers and the like. However, there is another type of victory which is creative and constructive. The victories of peace are more lasting and useful to humanity than the victories of war. This has been given to us. Now let us see. The word victory generally reminds us of wars and conquerors like Alexander and Napoleon. Thousands of people are killed and hundreds of towns and cities destroyed. Now here, the victories of Alexander and Napoleon, their victories of war, generally destructive in nature, where hundreds and millions of people die. And the same thought process is here. Thousands of people are killed and hundreds of towns and cities are destroyed. But the victory associated with the war comes after much destruction. Same thought process is even talked about here. Now, in this category, we may include achievements of scientists and scholars. Now, from here in R and S, the tone of the passage changes and it has become one of the contrast type. It has become one of the contrast type. Now, let us see. Now, in this category, which category are we talking about? We need to question that. However is an important keyword here. But is an important keyword here. But is an important keyword here. These two will go together, R and S, and P and Q will go together. Okay, P and Q will go together and R and S will go together. However, there is another type of victory which is creative and constructive. And this creative and constructive type of victory is being referred to in R as this category. So S is going to be followed by R. S is going to be followed by R. And S followed by R is here in option C, S followed by R. Here S is not followed by R. Here S is followed by R, but quite a lot in intervening. It will not be separated, so all these get eliminated. Let me try to fit in C. Let me see. But the victory associated with the war comes after so much destruction. Thousands of people are killed and hundreds of towns and cities are destroyed. This is going to be the first one. Q, P, then S. However, there is another type of victory which is creative and constructive. And in this category, we may include the achievements of scientists and scholars, statesmen and social reformers and the like. The victories of peace are more lasting and useful to humanity than the victories of war. My answer is C. C is my right answer. Next one now. There is nothing strange in the fact that so many foreign students should wish to learn English. There is nothing strange in the fact that so many foreign students should wish to learn English. If any valuable book is written in another language and English translation of it is sure to be speedily published. Anyone who masters the English tongue acquires the key. Most books found to be generally useful are written in English. The English speaking want no monopoly of knowledge. This key will open to him whatever is valuable in the literature of the world. This key, which key are we referring to? Which key are we referring to? We need to question that. We need to question which key is being referred to here. Okay. Now let us try to fit this in. Which key are we referring to? This is the key lies in sentence Q. Anyone who masters the English language acquires a key. Very clearly a key has been mentioned. So Q is going to be my last one. And where is Q as the last one? It is in option C. So let me try to fit it in. There is nothing strange in the fact that so many foreign students should wish to learn English. Most books found to be generally useful are written in English. Then P, if any valuable book is written in another language, an English translation of it, it means the book, is sure to be speedily published. Then S, the English speaking want no monopoly of knowledge. Anyone who masters the English tongue acquires a key. This key will open to him whatever is valuable in the literature of the world. Absolutely right. C is the right answer. C is the correct one. Next one. I take it that most people who talk glibly of science think of science merely as a kind of handmaiden to make their work easier. Of course, it does make their work easier, and so it does. All this science does. It adds to the wealth of the nation and better conditions. But surely, science is something more than that. This is the parajumble given to me. Now here if you see, and is my keyword. All this is very, very important keyword. Now here, it adds to the wealth of the nation and better conditions. Now here, of course, is also an important keyword here. What is going to be the order? The order is going to be QPSR. That is going to be the order. See, here it is saying, I think that most people who talk glibly of science think of science merely as a kind of handmaid, etc. This will be followed by, and so it is. It is a handmaid. Okay. Q will be followed by P. Of course, it does make work easier. This will be followed by S and then R. QPSR is the right order. QPSR is here. QPSR is here, and that is the answer. This was part 18 of Parajumbles. Part 18 of Parajumbles, extremely important. And now we shall move on to part 19 and 20. And let me just remind you that all these video lectures, they are a part of our program known as JobAssure 2, which is a specially designed program for Tier 2. I wish you all the best. Thank you.